Hi, I'm Rick Kirby, Vice President of Sales and Marketing here at Renkus-Heinz, and I'd like to talk to you for a few minutes about the latest innovation in beam steering technology, our ICONYX Generation 5. Now, chances are you're here watching this because you've heard of Renkus-Heinz, or you've heard of ICONYX, or maybe you've heard about beam steering and you've heard that we're the leaders in this technology. But I'd like to start off then by talking a little bit about beam steering in general and why we do this in the first place. We've all been in places where it's difficult to hear what's coming across the PA system, be it a paging message at an airport telling us that our flight's been delayed, or a night out at the theatre or the opera, or maybe watching a sermon, listening to a sermon in church. The basic problem in all of these environments is the interaction between the loudspeaker system and the room the loudspeakers are in. Even a very good traditional loudspeaker is still going to spray the sound fairly indiscriminately around the room. And it's that interaction, those reflections off the ceiling, the walls, and the hard surfaces in the room that create these reverberations and echoes that degrade intelligibility and make it more difficult for people to hear. With a product like ICONYX and digitally beam steering, we're able to create very tight beams of sound, as tight in some cases as 5 degrees. And we can electronically steer these, ensuring that the sound only covers the intended audience areas and the listeners that we want to be able to hear. And it doesn't touch the ceiling or the walls, so this reverberation is never created. In environments where we need to cover multiple audience areas, or if we have a particularly deep audience area and we need to maintain a similar level from front to back, we can actually shoot multiple beams to cover that audience. And each one of those beams can be individually tailored, not just in how much of the room they're going to cover, but how loud they're going to cover it. So each of these can be turned up and down independently, so we can ensure a uniformity not just in coverage, but also level throughout the intended coverage area. Depending on the room configuration and where the loudspeakers are mounted, we can even fire beams up from the columns to cover maybe a balcony area. And that means we can cover those spaces without having to add additional dedicated loudspeakers. So that, in essence, is what ICONYX and beam steering is all about. It allows us to project intelligibility. We can project clear, intelligible sound into spaces that aren't necessarily acoustically ideal. ICONYX Generation 5 is a range of 7 steerable loudspeakers ranging from 1 to 4 meters tall, with each step up in size representing either an increase in output power and throw distance or an increase in beam control. Now, in order to create these very tight beams of sound, the column must be relatively large in relation to a wavelength of sound. And the taller the column, the lower in frequency we're able to create those tight beams. So our 1 meter tall column can control sound, even though it's a full range loudspeaker playing from bass all the way through to treble. That loudspeaker can control and steer sound from about 800 hertz and up. In contrast, our 4 meter tall column, the IC32, can create and control beams from 200 hertz and up, making it absolutely ideal for really difficult reverberant spaces like old traditional cathedrals or corporate atriums where there's lots of glass and hard surfaces, maybe a marble floor involved, but we still need to get intelligible sound across to the intended listeners. In fact, one good example is the Church of Padre Pio in Italy, where we cover 6,500 people with just 2 loudspeakers. The throw distance is 65 meters, and 2 IC32s cover that entire space, and everyone's blown away by the results. The range is created from 2 basic building blocks, the IC8 and the IC16-8, which are combined together to create this range of 7 loudspeakers. Let's start by considering just the IC8, which is our 1 meter tall column. Now, this column is a tight pack array of 8 4-inch transducers, and each one of those 4-inch transducers has 3 small high-frequency transducers on the front of it. Every device in this column, each one of those 8 transducers, has its own amplifier channel and DSP, or signal processing channel, and that's built straight into the loudspeaker. It's what we call a self-powered loudspeaker. By connecting a computer to the column, we can then download settings that create these tight beams and then allow us to steer them up or down, open and close the angles of them, and then turn them up and down in level. So when we encounter applications where we need either more output level or the room's too reverberant and we need tighter beam control, so we have to step up from the IC8, we can simply stack another one on top or another one on top of that. And so by taking these tight packed 8 driver modules and stacking them up to 4 tall, we can create the IC8, 16, 24 and 32 loudspeakers, each one, as I've said before, offering a step up in output level and in beam control. Now, there are applications where perhaps we're in a very reverberant room, and we don't need that step up in output level, but we do need that step up in beam control. For those applications, with Gen 5, we've introduced the 16.8, which is a new loudspeaker for us. Instead of this tight pack of 8 4-inch devices, with the 16.8, we actually have 3 of our 4-inch coax devices at the bottom of the column, and then 5 progressively spaced 4-inch woofers above that. In fact, these 16.8s can also be combined with the IC8 to create many more column types. So we have, for example, a 24.16, which is an IC8 with a 16.8 on top, and we also have a 32.24. This gives us a very cost-effective solution to very reverberant spaces where we're focused mainly on speech intelligibility. As I've said before, all of these columns are self-powered, which means they contain all of the electronics, the amplification, the signal processing, the brains to create these type beams. But we have to program them, and we do this by very simply plugging a computer in using a standard Ethernet connection, and on that computer we call up our Rayon 2 software, which is our control suite. Using this software, we can create the type beams, equalize and balance the system, and once they're downloaded and programmed into the loudspeaker, we can simply take the computer away. Now, in larger applications where there are multiple loudspeakers, they can all be networked together on a standard Ethernet network and controlled from that one computer all at the same time. Now, of course, there may be applications where we do want to leave the computer connected. For example, where we want to monitor the system health, and each of these loudspeakers can report the driver integrity, its temperature, amplifier status. Or maybe we want to leave the computer connected so we can recall presets. Each loudspeaker can store multiple preset configurations, perhaps to turn balcony coverage on or off, or to reconfigure it for intelligibility versus music performance. We can do that with a computer connected, or we could add in a third-party control system, for example AMX or Crestron, that can simply connect to the same Ethernet network and send commands to the loudspeaker. So, Generation 5 takes the best steerable solution available on the market today, ICONYX, and makes it better. If you'd like more information, please visit our website, www.renkus-heinz.com, or give us a call to arrange a demonstration.